Namaskar to all. Myself, Dr. Sivakant Pathak, welcome to all of you in laboratory of truth, justice and dharma. And after welcoming you people, I feel presence of you in my heart, and this presence insists me to be in relationship with you. Today I will be with you with one fresh lecture of human value in Vedanta Darshan. The new lecture is in Human Value in Sankhya, Yoga and Vedanta Darshan. Is introduction of Yoga Darshan, subject matter of Yoga Darshan, and the level and state of mind. This is first lecture of Yoga Darshan, but 17th lecture of the subject Sankhya Yoga and Vedanta Darshan. So, in the whole of the Vedanta Darshan, we have finished Nyaya Darshan and Vaisheshik Darshan. Now we are going to start Yoga Darshan. So here in this Yoga Darshan, we will see the introduction of that. Yoga Darshan scripture is written by, presented by Patanjali, the Rishi. This Yoga Darshan is written by Maharshi Patanjali before Mahabharata, more than 5,000 years ago. The commentary is made by Vyas Master, by Maharshi Vyas, and also known as Maharshi Badar Narayan Vyas. The structure of the book is, there are four chapters in that, Samadhipada, in which there is a contemplation containing 51 slokas, sutras. Second chapter is Sadhana Param, meaning of emancipation, 55 formula, Vibhuti Param, Supernormal Param. The sutras are 56 and Kaivalya Param, ultimate goal, containing 34 formula. You get it? Now, we are going to see some terminology regarding the Yoga Darshan, Yoga philosophy, under the topic subject matter Yoga Darshan. The first terminology is here. Here means which is to be left at down or avoid pain, suffering, problems at individual level or at level of family or level of society or level of country or level of world, which is bound to come in the future. So see the meaning of a very carefully, which is to be left avoided. Pain, suffering, problem. Hate is related with reason, cause. This is cause of the way. Cause of way, way is called way hate. It is indiscriminate association of the perceiver and perceivable are seen. What are the reason for the hate? Pain, suffering, or problem. Harm. Absence of hetu means no reason for pain, suffering, and problem. So this is called absoluteness of the perceptivity on the cessation of hetu come absence of pain. This is called harm. Harm. Now we are going to see Hanupaya in Yoga Darshan. Hanupaya is Upaya. Hanupaya. Upaya. Hanupaya. Han plus Upaya. Means of achieving Hana. Hana means absence of here with you. Hanupaya is Kar Abhiplava Dipeg Khyati. Abhiplava Dipeg Khyati is called unwavering intellectual revelation. This Abhiplava Dipeg Khyati, that is Abhiplava, is the method of attaining freedom from pain. How can we go away from the pain and the misery forever? The method for attaining Hanupaya, this is Abhiplava Vivek Khyati, is called Astin Yoga. See, this Astin Yoga is method for attaining Abhiplava Vivek Khyati. And it is known as also Hanupaya or Hanupaya. See the method and principle and niyam. The first one is Ahimsa, no violence, non-violence. Sati, truthfulness. Truthfulness, truth. Sati means we will represent Sati in its more original and original form. Aste, no stealing. Aste means we will not take any object in presence of the master of the object. We will not take any object in absence of the master of object. Brahmacharya, celibacy, chastity. What is this? Brahmacharya is totally related with a relationship only with his wife. Sexual relationship, physical relationship only with wife. An aparigraha, non-possessiveness. And what are the niyam we will apply to get astanga? This is Abhiplava Vivek Khyati. The personal discipline rule is there. It is for purity of body, shauch. संतोष, कंटेंटमेंट, इंड्यूरेंस, तपस, स्टडी ऑफ स्क्रिप्चर्स, इंट्रोस्पेक्शन, स्वाध्याय, एंड देन यू विल बी फुल डेडिकेशन टू द गॉड ऑलमाइटी, ईश्वर प्रणिधान. So, there are five rules for the personal discipline. This is Saut, Santosh, Tapas, Swadhyay, or Ishwar Pranidhan. Now, for attaining all the Pallav, Vivek, Khyati, we have certain steps to know one by one. That is, first of all, we have to follow the M principles. The M principles in the previous slide, these five M principles: non-violence, truthfulness, non-stealing, celibacy, or non-possessiveness. So non-possessiveness, so we must follow this. Thereafter we have followed the niyam. These are five niyams for personal discipline. Then a comfortable and suitable posture for mental equilibrium. This is called asana. How we will sit here to obtain our ultimate goal. This is called asana. After asana, there is a pranayama. Pranayama is exercise to control the breath. Breathe. There is extension to take the breath, to keep the breath inside for sometimes, and then release the breath. Control and extension of the breath. Thereafter, the fifth step is a mental preparation to increase the power of mind. This is called pratyahara. And a mental preparation to increase the power of mind. By this, the mind can be utilized. Then dharana, concentration of mind on one particular object. Thereafter, the seventh step is meditation, dhyana, union, connected contemplation of the object, contemplation, chintan of the object without any resistance, without any resistance keeping in mind. That is called dhyana, meditation. And the last step, to obtain or deploy Vivek Khyati, is Samadhi, salvation. So we will see all those three. Now we want to see the state of mind or level of mind. During this, here in this slide, there for pranayama, we can see Yam follow, personal discipline, principles, then asana, pranayama, pratyahara, dharana, dhyana and samadhi for getting the liberation in life. The state of mind must be in sophisticated way, in such a way that during the meditation, no other things, no other type of ideas should arise in the mind. Since we know how this type of mind act, mind is possessed of three qualities, three type of energy. This is known as sattva, rajas and tamas. Sattva good promoted illumination, purity and virtue. Sattva good is for the purity of my impurity of a soul. Rajas denotes drive wealth movement activity either good or bad. So some good activity, bad activity, the position is just small. Thomas denotes inertia, dullness, inactivity, impurity, ignorance. Then it is called Thomas, Davis character. Gunas manifest in form of five mental state or mental level. This five mental state of mind is here one by one given. Gun manifest in form of five state of mind. In that, first is chit, distracted, dominated by the first quality rajas, mind is restless. Rajas guru, in which in rajas guru see this previous slide very carefully. Rajas denotes drivers, movement, activity, either good or bad, both type of quality. Rajas guru. More dominated by tapas, mind involved in stupid, wrong practices, without clarity about thought or action. No action is performed by right understanding, jnana. Third state of mind is vikshipt, partially concentrated. Partially concentrated vikshipt means sattva start dominating and now a mind is pulled back to the from sattva to rajas guna and tamas guna. Hence oscillates between this mind sattva to rajas and tamas. So when it is in rajas, right, sattva, right direction, when it is in side of rajas and tamas, it opposes clarity in the mind. Distracts them, right or wrong. It is difficult to obtain. So three types are distracted, chip, dull, move, vikshipt, partially concentrated, now ekagra. To get one point, sattva dominates completely, suppresses rajas and tamas guna, mind becomes relaxed, ready to concentrate for the meditation as long as we want. As long as we want, he can control his mind for a single thought. No other thought will come during that time in a minute. Inumi illuminates the reality, remove affliction of which causes suffering and losing the bondage of karma. Now, the fifth state of mind, niruddha, controlled, all guna abstracted, sattva, rajas and tamas. Mind reaches equilibrium of all three guna and it is ready to take samadhi. It is the supermost state of mind, obtaining the state of ultimate goal of the yoga. What is the ultimate goal of yoga play? A realization of coexistence, liberation, merge, paramananda ki prapti, attainment of paramananda. So here are five level of mind, that is the chit, move, vikshipt, ekagra and niruddha. So chit, move and vikshipt cannot be for obtaining avipallo vivek khyati. What is the avipallo vivek khyati? Hanupaya. हॉर्न प्लस उपाय. सी दिस इज द स्लाइड हियर. लेवल्स एंड स्टेट ऑफ माइंड शिफ्ट रेस्टलेस. सी द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड ऑफ द स्लाइड. इफ इट इज अ डज स्टूपिड थिंग लैक्स क्लैरिटी. देयर इज नो क्लैरिटी टू टेक एनी पॉइंट इन द माइंड. Always the brain is busy in doing the stupid and unethical things. Bit shift. This mind oscillates between one side is a sattva, another side is rajas and tamas, so it's oscillating with them. Now ekagra. Relax, ready to meditate. Illuminates the reality. And the last one, Nirudh. This is a state of equilibrium of mind. And when one person reaches at this level, he now starts moving towards the liberation to get ultimate goal of the life. So, if we want to get the ultimate goal of our life, we have to convert our brain from a state of chit to a state of ekagra to a state of nirudh. Then we can be ready for doing the work. Here in this lecture, we have given the Om principle, we have given the Niyam, and thereafter this, the other six steps to begin the liberation in the life. We will be continue with the meeting with you, but this is the last present lecture. At last, I want to speak only thing that you see all the lecture carefully. Try to understand the fact, not only understand, but implement in the life to get ultimate goal of life, that is the liberation, moksha, attainment of liberation, moksha ki prapti. This is only in the present lecture. At last, once more, namaskar to you.